Hey guys, what's up? Welcome to another video, and today I'm gonna show you how to make this very nice copper material over here. This is a beginner's guide for octane materials, so I'm gonna show you the techniques to create this material using a very simple steps, okay? So remember, you always can improve what I'm gonna show you, okay? So it's always good to try different things, different techniques, okay? But this is the basic. You can use it as a basic to start this kind of metal, okay? So let's get started. Okay, so I'm gonna delete this material and I'm gonna create one from scratch. So new material, and let's name it, and maybe let's use the proper name, copper. Okay, perfect. So the first thing I'm gonna do is change the metallic to 1. So now we have a metal material, right? Also the roughness, you kill it for now. And now we have a very clear chrome material right here. And I think the first property of a copper material is the color. Okay, so let's adjust the color on the albedo to something like this. Okay, so go to the albedo and change the color to something like this. Not bad. Maybe a little bit more. Orange. Can always desaturate it and control the saturation over here. I think it's something like this. Okay. Okay, so the next thing is to add a noise material. So Shift A, S to search, and noise texture. Oops, I think I lose it. Oh my god, let me create another one. Noise mature, noise text, here. And let's plug it on the bamp map, the bamp here. Yeah. Okay, so let's adjust the roughness over here. Yeah, something like this. Yeah, not bad. The reflection looks a little weird, so let's change the BRDF to Beckman. For me, I think the Beckman are the most realistic one for metals, okay? But you can always use like GGX as well. So Beckman, I think, is the best one for this purpose. Okay, so let's adjust a little bit the roughness again. So now we have a better reflection going on in this object. Okay, so the next thing we're gonna do is adjust the anisotropy over here. So let's set it to 1. And to see the result, actually, I'll increase a little bit the roughness. Something like this. So then when I set anisotropy to 1, you're gonna see that the directions of the reflection change. So here you can see, here you can control the rotation of these reflections, okay? So as you can see in the metals, the anisotropy works on the vertical shape. So here we have the anisotropy working on the vertical shape. If you change it, for example, to something like this one, the anisotropy, like the position of the reflection, it's not the same as in the real world. So you have to be careful about that, okay? So let's set it to 0, and here we go. Okay, so to make this a little bit more realistic, I'm gonna add bitmap, this over here, to create some imperfections on this material. Okay, so let's take a look. Let me import it here and let's plug it on the roughness. Now the object is too shiny because the value that we have set here on the roughness is not working anymore because we applied this bitmap on the roughness. So to control it, we have two options actually. Control the roughness using the gamma. Okay, so giving more contrast or reducing the contrast. Okay, so let's decrease gamma. Decreasing gamma, you're gonna see that you're gonna have this kind of a glossy material on the surface. Okay. Okay, and to control how strong this bitmap is gonna be, you can add a gradient map and connect between this bitmap and the universal material. And here, if you increase the white, you're gonna see that we are going to lose the effect of this bitmap applied. Okay, so be careful to not go too much. So let's still keep some scratches on the surface. And also I'm gonna apply full transform to this bitmap, and I will decrease the size of it. Okay, so let's put something like maybe 0.2 and let's take a look closely. Yeah, here we go. So now we have a very small scratch around this object, this surface, and probably this is still too much. We can always adjust it. Let me take a look closer. Yeah, maybe it's too much. Okay, so let's increase gamma a little bit more. Not bad. Let's play around with this gradient map here. Increase a little bit like the contrast. Okay, so now it's like less visible, not too much. Let me try to increase a little bit more the scale here, 0.5. Okay, so let's give more more reflection to this object. Maybe the gamma is too low. Let's increase it, something like this. And here in the gradient, let's increase the white a little bit more. Something like this. Yeah. It was too much. Okay, so now let's add a color variation to it. So I will duplicate this universal material over here. And I'm gonna add a mix material, this one. Connect the mix material to the surface, and this one to the material 2, and this one to the material 1. Perfect. Let's add a noise texture. and plug it on the amount. And let's just change the color here just to see what's going on. Maybe have to increase the contrast a little bit so you can see a little bit better what's going on over here. Okay. And let's change the color here. Dark a little bit. Let's see. Always good to add a color variation to your objects, as we did on the last video. Okay, so it brings more realism to the object. Okay, so that's it, guys. I hope you have enjoyed, and that's, as I said, that's the basic. You don't like always need to use the same techniques, and this is a little bit exaggerated. Maybe you can, I don't know, just don't use this rough, this bitmap on this channel, and just use the bitmap on the second channel, that this one. So like this, you don't have you won't have like too many scratches on your object as well, just on some parts of it. Okay, so maybe this can be a nice trick as well. Okay, yeah, thank you very much, guys, and I hope you have enjoyed it, and see you in the next video.